In this screencast, I want to describe the process of reverse osmosis, in which we use a membrane to obtain a pure solvent from a solution of a solvent and a solute. In particular, this is the process that's used to obtain water from salt water. And the idea is that we have a membrane that's permeable to water, but almost impermeable to the salt. So before talking about reverse osmosis, let's look at what the process of osmosis is. If we were to put water on one side of a membrane, and let's say we have them at the same height, so the same hydrostatic pressure on both sides. So we have water plus a solute on the left side, and we have pure water on the other side. This means that the chemical potential of the water on side one is less than the chemical potential on side two because the water concentration, the mole fraction of water on side one, is less than the mole fraction of water on side two. As a result, we have a driving force for permeation. What we're going to see is that the water, so we're going to have flux of water across this membrane from the right side to the left side, to try and equalize the chemical potentials. We can also write this as the fugacity of water on the left side is less than the fugacity of water on the right side, where I've used this symbol to indicate that we have a solution, and on the right side is pure water. So if we let this system go to equilibrium, this drawing now represents equilibrium, which means the chemical potential water on the left side is the same as the chemical potential water on the right side, and therefore there is no flux. The way this happens is that now the pressure on the left side is greater than the pressure on the right side. As we increase the pressure, we increase the chemical potential, and we continue to have water moving from the right to the left until we get to this equilibrium situation. And so this delta P is the osmotic pressure. So this would be the equilibrium situation. In reverse osmosis, what we do is increase the pressure by an external means on the left side in order to permeate water to the right side. So what I've represented here in the third figure now is the idea of reverse osmosis. The idea is we've created additional pressure. Here I've shown it as a hydrostatic pressure, but in reality we're going to pressurize up the liquid with a pump. So now the chemical potential water on the left side is greater than the chemical potential water on the right side. Therefore, we're going to have flux of water. So the water flux is going to be in this direction. Remember, this membrane is permeable to water, but it's almost impermeable to the salt, right? We have water plus salt here, and what we're going to form then is essentially pure water on the right side. Indeed, this is the dominant process for desalinating salt water or brackish water, meaning water with a lower concentration than seawater. Seawater has about 3.5 weight percent of solute. It's also used to treat some food products to dewater them. So for seawater, the osmotic pressure is about 24 bar. So if we're going to do reverse osmosis, that means we have to have a pressure on the feed side that's higher than 24 bar, and typical values are 55 to 70 bar. So let's look at our equilibrium situation again. We have the chemical potential on the left side equal to the chemical potential on the right side. And we can also write this as the fugacity on the left side is the fugacity on the right side. And the fugacity would be the mole fraction of water, an activity coefficient, and the fugacity of pure water, this is zero indicating pure water, and this is at pressure P1. The right side is Now we'll assume pure water, but it's at a different pressure. And then typically this is going to be close to one because this is close to one. If this were 0.98, for example, that's a pretty good approximation that the activity coefficient is close to one. So we have the mole fraction of water times the fugacity of pure water at this pressure equals fugacity at a different pressure. And so what we're going to use to relate the fugacities at the different pressures is the Poynting correction. So this is the Poynting correction. It says the fugacity at pressure P1 for pure water is equal to fugacity of pressure P2 times an exponential. So pressure difference. This term is the volume per mole of the liquid. Gas constant and absolute temperature. We've been talking here about equilibrium, which means P1 minus P2 is our osmotic pressure. So now let's look at reverse osmosis. So we're going to have water permeating through the membrane in this direction. The flux of the water, okay, so this is flux, moles per area per time. The flux of the water, so the flux, it turns out, is proportional to a permeability. This is a property of the membrane. The thickness, thicker membrane has a lower flux. And then the pressure on the feed side minus this quantity, pressure and permeate side, plus the osmotic pressure. Because remember, if this pressure difference, this we'll call this pressure difference across the membrane, was equal to the osmotic pressure, there'd be no flux. So we have to have a pressure difference greater than the osmotic pressure to have reverse osmosis. So here's the equation for the water flux. The higher pressure on the feed side causes water to permeate through. We could have a small amount of salt, not a perfect membrane, so we could also look at the flux of the salt, which may be related to the diffusivity of the salt in the membrane, again divided by the membrane thickness. And now we would have the concentration of the salt. This would be on in the membrane right at the edge. So if the membrane your side one and side two, that would be the concentration right here. Call that prime. And then the concentration right here. And what we can do is relate this to a partition coefficient for the solute. And then write the concentrations in solution. So these now are the concentrations. This is liquid of salt plus water on side one. This is almost pure water, but a very low concentration of salt. So the concentration here is this concentration, and the concentration here is this concentration. So this is a partition coefficient that's, as you can see from the equation, related to the salt concentration in, or the solute in general, concentration in the membrane, the solute concentration in the liquid right next to the membrane. Now, this is independent of delta P. So as the pressure difference becomes larger, we would increase the flux of the water. We wouldn't increase the flux, the salt diffusing through the membrane, so we would actually then increase the purity of the water on the right side. This idea of reverse osmosis is what's used to create high purity water from salt water. And it's certainly much more energy efficient than if we would do distillation of salt.